In today's video, we're diving into Google Tasks. I'll be showing you everything you need to do to get up and running with Google Tasks. This is Google's very simple but powerful to-do list tool, and there are three different ways to access Google Tasks. First would be from within Gmail or Google Calendar, like so. Over here on the sidebar, you'll see a little task check mark. If you click that option there, all of your tasks and lists will be shown here on the sidebar. The same works for Google Calendar. As you can see on the sidebar, the task shows up here. If I click it, the little sidebar and my task list will pop up. If I want to, I can hit the little arrow with a square to open Google Tasks in full screen. Another way of getting here is just going to tasks.google.com and logging into your account. And then lastly, there is a mobile app for both Android and iOS, and I'll be talking about that later on in the video. So first things first, creating your first task. In order to create your first task, it's very simple. You go right here to create, click on create. As you can see, you have the task's name or title here, the date in which you want to get it done, if it's an all-day task, whether it repeats or not, and a task description. And then you can assign it to a specific list. Think of a list as a project or a different grouping of tasks to show separately from your normal ones. So you can add a task just like so. So we'll go ahead and say this is task one, and then go ahead and go to save or hit enter. And as you can see, all of the details and the task information shows up under my main list here within Google Tasks. In order to check something off, you just hit the little circle there and it checks that off as completed. If you want to change the details on a task, it's as simple as going here, clicking into the task. We can remove words. We can go here and add details. We can change the date that we want it to, you know, be due at. All of those things can be done here. And again, when you're done, you just hit the little circle and it's been marked as completed. Now, if you want to add something directly to a specific list, like here's my YouTube list, I can go to add a task, and then I can go ahead and it pops up the option here where I can go and just add a task that easily, and then hit enter, and that task has already been added. And when you access this from the Gmail or Google Calendar sidebar, if we go here, go to that list, you can see that task has been added, and we can check that task off from wherever and however we're accessing our Google Tasks. Next, we're going to be talking about creating lists or projects here within Google Tasks. In order to do that here, what you would need to do is where you see your list, it may be covered up, but if you go ahead and expand that out here, you'll see a button that says create new list. Give that list a name, so we'll say podcast, and then we'll go ahead and hit enter. And as you can see, we have a new list available to us over here. We can always click and hold and drag these lists like so to rearrange them via importance or how we want to see them throughout the day. And then if you wanted to, you could always go up here to the list options and then click on that. And then you can see here, we can delete or rename that list like so. That's how you get to the list options. If you want to rearrange tasks, as you see, I have multiple tasks here. I can click and hold and drag them either below or above the current task. I can also star them to favorite them and make them appear at the top of my list to add a priority. Or you can add emojis like a fire emoji to let you know this task is important. There isn't any built-in priority system, so you will have to either favorite, star, or add emojis so you can signify to yourself these need to be prioritized. In order to do a recurring task, you would go to create a new task like so. And then when you are adding that task, like I am here, you have the option that says do not repeat. You can hit that drop-down menu and you can say that this is going to repeat every day. This is going to repeat weekly on Tuesdays or monthly or annually, or you can do custom. So by doing custom here, you can say this repeats every 2 days at a certain time, but we'll go ahead and do one weekly on Tuesdays like so. And then as you can see, if I hit save, this is going to pop up every Tuesday as a task that is recurring until you go here and either remove the repeating by the X here or go to this option where it says task options and then go to delete. And then it says delete repeating task and then you delete all of them. So that's how you add repeating or recurring tasks as well as removing them when you are done doing it. Now let's briefly hop into the Google Tasks mobile app. As you can see, here is the Google Tasks app on iOS. It'll look the same over on Android. When you open it up and log into your Google account, you'll see your different lists at the top. As you can see, I have multiple lists. I can add new lists by just going to the far right, tap on new list, and then go ahead and enter a list name like I'm doing here, and that will add a new list, and it will also sync between this and the desktop version as well. And then if you want to add a new task, it's as simple as tapping the addition symbol there, adding a task like so. You can do all the things by tapping that there to add details. You can tap the clock to make it recurring or a specific date and time, and you could even star it to make it a favorite or priority, and then hit save, and then that's going to be added and synced across all of your different devices. This is a very simple, yet like I said, very powerful to-do list manager. There's no subscription, you don't have to pay for it, it's available everywhere, it's easily accessible in both Gmail and Calendar like I've shown you here. It's one of those tools that is just there and it just works. Hopefully this helped you. If it did, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.